today. Oh, I've been having a lovely time. The inside of Bob's mouth is so clean, I've set up camp. Okay, so I have to run for cover now and again, meal times and so on. And it can get quite rough in here when he's exercising. But I've learned to hang on. I feel quite at home here now. Trouble is, no one calls to pick up the rubbish.
Hey, you in there?
Yes?
Look, I don't mind you looking around so that you can learn something about the perfect body.
A perfect body, indeed.
But haven't you heard the phrase, take your rubbish home? I'm getting a little bit concerned about all the waste that you're producing and leaving in various places in my mouth. I don't mind you, but your rubbish I can do without.
Waste. Just about everything you do produces waste. Just think of the number of times in a day you throw something away. People produce masses of waste, things they no longer need. Bits of paper, boxes, newspapers. At least these days we've started to think about doing something useful with our rubbish and recycling it. Can you think of any examples in your area? Machines create waste too. Think of cars and planes and boats. Putting something in one end and you can be pretty sure that something else comes out the other end, which is waste, not needed. And not very nice sometimes. In factories too, the raw materials needed to make the end product in the factory are used up at the beginning, and there will always be waste produced. Our bodies are machines too. They need raw materials to make them work. Can you remember what they are?
Good food, good drink, and clean air.
I thought that you might know. Why are you listening to me anyway?
It's all very interesting. I like being compared to a machine. A mean machine!
Well, I certainly wish that I could switch you off sometimes.
I'll pretend I didn't hear that. Go ahead, then.
Thank you. Right, where was I? Bob said that the important things that the body needs to work are good food and drink and clean air. Bodies are like power stations. Take in fuel and produce energy. Let's start by following the path of some fuel, food and drink. See if we remember where it goes and why. And more importantly, sort out the waste problem. Down the food pipe into the stomach where the food is broken down into smaller bits, nutrients, and then into a long tube. This is the small intestine. Now, these finger-like things, called villi, are full of blood vessels. And the nutrients are so small, they can pass into the blood vessels through the walls here. But the small intestine isn't small at all. In fact, it's really long, so excuse me while I struggle along. Oh, looks as if there's more food on the way. Banana sandwich and orange juice. This is the large intestine. By the time the food has reached here, all the good bits, the nutrients, are in the blood, travelling round the body. So what's left behind? The waste. All the bits of food that weren't digested are too big to pass into the blood. The body can't use them. The body has to get rid of them.
Mm-hmm.
But before the waste goes out, the body makes sure that it has taken all the water. Water is very important. We need every drop. So here in the large intestine, the water goes back into the blood through these walls, leaving behind solid waste. And to help the body get rid of the waste every day, it's important to eat food with plenty of fibre in it. I suppose you eat plenty of fibre every day, Bob.
Good morning, ladies and gents. I'm so glad to see you want your bodies to work better. Fibre every day clears all that waste away. That's what I always say. Frankly, I can't get enough. Roughage.
Roughage? What's roughage?
Roughage is food with fibre in it. Fibre is rough. It gets into the large intestines and helps clear all the waste away. Helps the body to get rid of it all. Out of the way. Otherwise, if you find it hard to get rid of the waste, you start feeling... Ugh. They call it constipation, you know. Know what I mean?
Yes.
Mm.
But does food with fibre just go in and out the other end then?
Food with fibre in it has lots of other good things too. The other good things get into the blood, leaving the fibre to do the pushing out. Anyway, enough of this. What can I get you from the fabulous Fibre Cafe? A vegetable curry and rice? Wholemeal spaghetti bolognese? Mixed bean chili with rice? Pork and vegetable stir fry? Jacket potato with tasty filling? Summer pudding, lots of fruit and bread? Laird muesli pudding? Fruit salad with prunes and peaches. So what do we want?
Fibre!
What don't we want?
Constipation! Yeah!
So what happens next? You go to the toilet, out comes the waste, the large intestine is empty again and ready for the next lot.
Excuse me?
Oh, hello. Still listening then, are we?
Well, I don't know about you, but when I go to the toilet, water comes out too. I thought you said that the body needs it and it gets taken back in.
Yes, yes, yes. That's wastewater, urine. And that comes from somewhere completely different. And to find out where, I need to get back into the blood. So hang on, I'll just get rid of this lot.
Oh!
Hello there. Oh, not bad, eh? Remember this? Whoop! I'm inside the blood. It's pumped around by the heart and flows to every single little bit of the body. These are the red blood cells. They make blood look red. But all around me, there is a fluid called plasma, and that carries the food around too. The food is so small now, it's a liquid, so you can't really see it. Now, as the nutrients are used up by the body to give you energy, so waste products are produced, just like in a factory or a power station. And some waste products are poisonous. So the body has a very clever little system to clean the blood. You have two of them. Your kidneys. They're around here somewhere. Oh, yes! A kidney. About 1,800 litres of blood pass through Bob's kidneys each day in order to be cleaned. 1,800 litres, mind you. From the outside, kidneys look just like kidney beans. How do you think kidney beans got the name? Bob's kidneys are about 12 centimetres long and 3 centimetres thick. They are just above the waist on either side of the spine. The kidney is amazing. It's full of tubules. There are about a million of these tubules in each kidney. And each one acts like a filter. You know what a filter does?
It separates things.
So, the blood comes into the kidney to be cleaned. The good, clean blood is allowed to carry on its journey through the body, and the waste material and the poisons are filtered out. The kidney ends up full of a yellow liquid called urine. But how does it get out of the body? Oh, no! Something peculiar is happening. Hey, let me back in. I haven't finished yet, Bob. Can't you do something? I'm getting really wet in here.
The kidney is filtering you out. Well, I don't blame it. You're not doing anything useful, are you?
Huh. What would happen if your kidneys didn't work properly? What would happen to all that dirty blood?
Some people need special machines to clean their blood. They're called dialysis machines.
Basically, dialysis is where we clean your body of poisons through an artificial kidney using two methods. We either have a line in your chest or an access from the arm where we put needles, and the blood comes out of your body, goes round an artificial kidney, gets all the poisons taken away, and then it's pumped back into your body.
So the blood comes out of the body through the tube, into the machine, is cleaned, and then is carried back into the body. Patients have to have dialysis twice a week for about 12 hours each time. I wonder what it feels like.
You shouldn't feel any pain or any discomfort at all with dialysis. If somebody phones up and they didn't want to come in for dialysis, if they're going out or they're not feeling very well, we have to explain to them they will die if they don't have dialysis. If it's a child, they will have to come twice a week regularly, and then with any luck they can go home with a machine and their mum or dad can dialyse them at home after we've trained them. If a person carries a donor card with them and something happens to them, they're in an accident and they can't use their kidneys anymore, we can then use that kidney to save somebody's life on the machine.
Do you carry a donor card? After leaving the kidneys, the urine flows into a tube, and because most people have two kidneys, you have two tubes, which empty into a big storage balloon called the bladder. Oh, it's like a balloon with muscles. It fills up with urine and stretches, and when you go to the toilet, it shrinks again. Did you know that Bob makes about a litre and a half of urine in a day? He could fill 2.5 milk bottles. Bob, you've gone very quiet. Ah! Waste from the toilet goes down the drain and into the sewage treatment works, where it flows or is carried around to be cleaned. First of all, the large objects are removed from the sewage, things like paper and rags. This is called a screen. In this tank, the solid bits of waste sink to the bottom. Cleaner water from the surface flows to the next important place. Here, tiny and very useful bacteria eat any dirt left in the water, leaving nice clean water in the last tank where any bits left over are removed. Hey presto, clean water flows into the river. Hello there. I've just had a hot shower and I'm feeling much better, much cleaner. So we've dealt with two waste products, solid and liquid. Is there another one? Let's think what else comes in the body. Bob, you know when we talked about the raw materials that a body needs to make energy? Well, we've talked about food and drink. What was the other one?
Clean air.
Clean air. I'm sure that the air you breathe is always clean, Bob. You don't look as if you smoke. You look too fit somehow.
No way. Of course not. But I don't think the air in this room will be clean, do you?
Oh, Bob! Lungs. So what happens in here then? Well, the air comes in and fills these air sacs here. There are thousands of them. There's something very important in air called oxygen that we all need, remember? Well, it gets into the blood here and is carried around the body so that it gets to every single place. But what do you breathe out? Not oxygen, because you use it up. Yes, you breathe out waste. The waste is called carbon dioxide. It's collected by the blood and comes in here, and then it goes out of the body every time you breathe out. Is that clever or what?
Yes, it's amazing. Now, will you get out?
Hang on, Bob. I just want to show what happens to people's lungs when they smoke. Blood used to smoke, you know. Remember what I found in her lung? Imagine if she had carried on. What might have happened to her? Smoking can kill. Some people have had very lucky escapes. In this hospital, they treat patients who have very serious problems with their lungs. Some people need to use a machine to help them breathe. Look at these lungs. They're from patients who died from lung cancer. Those people smoked. Bob, do me a favour just for a second. Go back into that smoky room, will you?
Okay, if I must.
Right, breathe in. See? Other people smoke getting into your lung, Bob. Can't do much harm, did you say?
Okay, you've seen enough. Let's get out of here.
There's an army out there you can join. They're cool, they're brave, they're the smoke busters.
Smokebusters is the name of our club, and it was started last October. It was started because we wanted to persuade children our age and older to stop smoking. We have about 50 members in our school. We get to do lots of things, sports, get to go down to the sports centre.
One of the things we do in the club, for example, is to keep fit. And most of the time, we go down to the sports centre to play football.
In our club, we had a competition with posters. The competition was to create the best poster to tell people not to smoke.
In the club, we also have a magazine. We get the chance to write letters and sometimes jokes.
One of the things you have to do before joining the club is to sign a piece of paper saying that we will never smoke.
Well, it's been a long, hard day, but it hasn't been wasted. Well, are you happy now, Bob? It looks nice and clean in here.
Yes, much better. Thank you, Elin.
You're welcome. Night, Bob.
Night, Elin.
Hey, Bob. Isn't it time we had a party?
Yes, next time.
Next time. Bye. It's been a pleasant journey, right from the start. To wander through your various bits and get to every part. Your mouth's so clean, I made it my camp. It gets a little rough, it's often rather damp. Your kidneys were amazing, your stomach's a treat. Your bladder wasn't funny, but your liver was neat. Exercise makes your muscles so strong. Your bones are hard, I could find nothing wrong. I went to see your lungs, they're nice and pink. I visited your brain, I watched you think. Bob, it's been nice to visit you and see that all is hunky-dory and you're healthy.